your shit. Get the fuck back and suck my dick. I'm a bad bitch, I'm about to kill shit. Motherfuckers, we all are in the business. I'm a bad bitch, I'm about to kill shit. Get the fuck back and suck my dick. I'm a bad bitch.
Thank you. ancestors are fear of natural disasters, disease, and death. Human history in every culture. We found ways to address our fear of natural disasters, disease, and death. The response to the profound mystery of birth, life itself, and what could possibly come after it has taken the form of what is called the rituals. Dark places.
Underground. underground sound like a thunder cloud rolls from the sewer, but we stand at the summit now. It's like a drug, but there ain't no way we're coming down. Stun the crowd with the sound of the underground. Fucking with no other sound. Stun the crowd with the sound of the underground.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to week one, game one of Squad Masters League. I believe we're going to be starting here on round one, starting on the side of Oneshot Gaming. They're taking on SPH and Exodus Coalition. Let me get my squad up, or my cast thing up here.
Curl, open curl. Remember, combat engineers open.
I'll run back here. And here we go.
Oh, is that just the rules?
Yes, yes, that's fucking against the rules. So.
Yeah, no, was it?
Назначен новый командир.
Wait, the rules? I'm missing one. Start.
Just don't touch your car's handbrake. Do not inch it forward.
So it looks like Oneshot might be taking a ticket penalty here if this is going live. I'm not sure, or if we're flipping maps here. But Oneshot Theory, or Oneshot Gaming, rolling their one Logitruck ahead a little bit. Not sure if they're going to give him a ticket penalty for that or not.
Way to push it from that road.
But, yeah, you're not allowed to move vehicles in main in staging phase. Vehicles for this match.
Do we have that guy that's missing?
Two 30mm BTRs. A Crow Tiger. Open Top Tiger. A BMP-2. They also get three Logitrucks. A delayed transport. Delayed tank. And delayed choppers. On the British side, two delayed choppers again, a tank, one warrior.
Zep, remember you're dropping that.
One
list
crow, bulldog, one open top bulldog, I believe, an LPPV, a transport on delay.
All right, listen,
and
my guys
three
are still gonna push
Logitrucks
west,
as well.
We're gonna inch a little bit. Up
wrong
from
key there.
West and do a little bit recon. We'll give you intel when we get there.
Pretty sure we're going live here, or what
copy
are we doing?
Coast Guard. We're gonna set up this front line on green mark.
Copy that.
As chat seems to be going off here, I know. Personally, the teams I've played on, we do not talk in chat. That's a big no-no. Focus on the game. Focus on playing.
40.
But I can understand wanting to wish the other team luck.
We got a caster
so
as one. So caster is DJGunny. That's why it's 42.
So I'm not sure what teams are.
Who's here that's not supposed to be here?
So there's looking like Oneshot might actually have one player too
many.
Did we
assume the Tralala wasn't coming and then he came?
So Oneshot's going to have to drop a player here.
Why do we got nine guys on?
Where's the extra?
Game
dump
starting
Bobby
in 5,
now.
4, 3, 2, 1. And here we go. We are live. Vehicles
dump
starting up. Vehicles rolling out. Oneshot Gaming. Logitruck's going first.
What's that? You want me to dump him?
Yeah, we have the next one.
We're going to turn on. Fly speed here so I can move a bit quicker. As we zoom in on the map here, open it up, you can see.
Hey, Tishar, you're back.
Oneshot Theory, Oneshot Gaming, sorry,
yes.
Coming out of main.
Copy that.
With fairly quick rollout, you can see all the markers on the map for where these squads are going to go. This match and this map is going to end up coming down to the two middle points. Yevnivka and West Stepney being the two predominant cap zones that the teams are going to be fighting over. As we see here, looking at the map, British rolling out of main, Logitrucks in the lead, the Bulldogs and such coming up, bringing up the rear. With the choppers being on a delay, you're not going to see the immediate quick to the point gameplay like you usually do, seeing the choppers rush West Stepney and Yevnivka. Teams are going to have to roll in with the Logitrucks, and it's going to take some time to get them in there. as it's looking like British are just now starting to get up to East Novo. And the Russians just about getting their first two Logi trucks towards Yevnivka, as we see both 30 mils rolling up the main road. Now, both those 30 mils can make it to that intersection up near where the squad move markers are and ambush Logi trucks as they're coming up the road if they're a little slow.
Heli's alive.
And there, as you just hear the call out, Heli's are in game now. As we're here flying over around towards West Stepney.
Copy.
Seeing. Who do we got
here?
My
guy's pushing into the west side of West Stepney.
Squad dropping off on the south or the north side of West Stepney here. They're going to probably get a fob up inside that building. And then down to the
Hilo 1, Hilo 2 inbound.
In the valley, getting a fob and radio up. They're going to get a hab and they're going to start pushing into the town. A little bit slow here getting towards into the town, though, from SPH and EXD. As you can see, smoke's being shot off already. Not sure what they're smoking off or shooting off. They're the only people inside the cap so far. Just telling the other team, hey, we're here. Here comes the first chopper, doing a resupply. No contact yet between either team.
I gotta get out of here.
Actually, no. Chopper might go down here. Warrior taking down Nanner in the chopper.
Yeah. No helis past the front line, gentlemen.
Good kill there. Sounds like one shot has mortars up on Yevnivka. Got rallies.
A squad 4 pushing up to do recon.
And we're pushing up on the west side.
Mortars coming from the southwest
of the map on Yevnivka. Squad 6 on the British up in the hills over there to the west as well. On the west flank of the guys on the flank of you of Stepney. Looks like those one-shot mortars are more or less hitting on friendly vehicle or friendly people almost. Captain Franklin might be getting a little bit of friendly fire there from those mortars as an EXD squad, Exodus, pushing up into gas station on Stepney. That gas station used to be part of the cap zone on Stepney. It is no longer part of that cap zone, as you can see by the wire box. And it looks like we have an SPH squad getting into contact over here. Looks like we have Biggie going down, as well as Achilles.
Okay, we don't have enough units on our back.
Costguard Martin takes down one. But getting taken out as he's trying to fight against an entire squad here pushing.
Enemy mortars just now targeting our
Crub team. Rex is the only one left. And gets taken out, doesn't even get a kill. Doesn't look like he even wounded anyone.
Keeping infantry marked mortars.
As we see, mortars landing pretty accurately on this north side.
West side. We came
to or sorry, south side.
Group of 4 pushing up. Squad 7, know his marksman can get in position, start taking them out.
Looks like this is going to be another squad game where all I hear all game is just mortar fire, mortar fire, mortar fire.
Tell your guy, 7, tell your guy on one's attack marker there.
Looks good cinematically, gets really, really bloody annoying. Ooh! Crispy getting taken out by a direct hit from that mortar. Unlucky. These mortars are going to make it difficult for EXD and SPH to push into the town. But at the same time, it means OS isn't going to be able to push down to this side of the town. As we take a quick look here, East Novo looks like it might be getting capped as we speak. West Petrivka is getting capped.
That was the goal of our Coast Guard.
No No super pushes, no super flanks we can see so far. Those two EXD guys off to the west are taken down.
Accurate at markers, just straight east of town at West F.
As we see up here on the hills, or right over here, looks like it's the, that's not the warrior, that's the, I can't remember what the name of the vehicle is. I'm drawing a complete blank. Someone will correct me in chat, I know that.
Infantry close on 6th position.
Squad 4 here, pushing around, trying to flank onto the west side, push down towards the FOB on Stepney. But OS, with a good presence here, taking out 1, 2, 3 bodies.
Stepney's getting overrun.
Looks like 4 bodies down. Or no, Dave Thing is still up.
It's consolidating on west.
West Stepney is getting pushed. EXD able to get into the town. Starting to clear the buildings, starting to work their way up the streets. As the mortars from Oneshot keep falling everywhere around them. SPH also able to push into and take that east side as well. As we see here, Franklin taking down Carl. I think a frag just went over the fence. And Franklin taken down by frag. Good grenade throw there. As we see Scrub taking down Infernus. And he also took down Chikebox, I believe that is. So one shot starting to clear out the flank. Take it back. Both. All the SPH guys getting picked back up and bandaged. Lawler bounding over the fence, takes out Strike. Or Snix. Kills the snake in the grass. There's one left. Communist. He's just gonna camp in the corner and hide for now. Sounds like a marksman in the field. Starting to take down. So we got Fazcat over here. And down goes two more Brits. Carl's still up.
Frog's down, it's west end.
Your radio place needs to be adjusted.
And down he goes. They finally found him. So that's the east flankers completely taken out now. For EXD and SPH. Kip getting hit by a explosive, getting tagged a little bit there.
Just came back up.
But we got Elite Sniper upstairs. Looks like he just GL'd, but he gets taken down. But not before he took out Puffle. So EXD getting some control over the cap zone. However,
it's not confirmed.
Yevnifka is being capped by OS and EXD, SPH have no presence over there right now. And Oneshot has enough of a presence here, they might actually be able to start taking this cap zone back. However, see here, is this half down or no? Oh, the radio's down a stage. That's why it's not spawnable. Mortars, I don't know why they put this radio here out in the open. That was a big mistake. These mortars able to start taking it down, make this spawn point unspawnable. Captain Franklin trying to come in clutch here and save this radio. Sitting there digging it up. Radio's still damaged now that it's not usable.
Charge.
Those mortars are close, but just not quite on target.
Yeah, he's got a body.
We need him starting soon. Yeah,
he'll wait. I just let's get this.
EXD.
No, we have
only have two people left alive inside the cap zone here on West Stepney. So once you have Nifka's capped,
I need armor squads.
They're going to start being able to push back in here. One shot, definitely. If they can get that hab back up, that fob back up, they have the advantage as their spawn point is a lot closer to the cap zone. As EXD and SPH have to cross this giant open field here to be able to get into the cap. Though it does look like they are getting a new fob up on gas station.
No more build. They just blew a helicopter right over here in Ivka. They are popping
up
and take down this
pop. Let's take a quick look here at the big map. See what's going on. So we have a couple bodies back here still at East Novo, but that's not important. Does look like Squad 6 is starting to get a flank on the Evnifka cap zone. And EXD got the bodies back inside the cap zone on the south side of Stepney, but let's head over here and take a look at this three-man flank. Four-man flank going on. Or sorry, no, three-man flank, that's a rally. I'm mistaking. Nobody knows they're over here yet. They could sneak in and do some damage, but there is a full squad sitting back here on this cap zone defending it.
I was pushing up the squad.
They did manage to sneak around that squad on the west side there of Yevnifka. And it looks like SPH has a squad starting to push across the pond. Two rallies here. They're going to know that this squad is coming here because they're going to hit those two rallies and crush them.
West side of West Step, enemy contacts unknown.
Possible swamp lab, yes or no?
No.
As both those rallies go down, so they should know that there's people coming through over here. But does not look like anybody's reacting to it yet. Ollie, actual going down, or actually Ollie going down. And rally replaced by an SPH rally. So, three-man squad pushing from the north, and a five-man squad pushing from the south. West side of Yevnifka, they're gonna start pushing in here and start causing some problems.
They're crossing the street now.
As we see Mixed and Dizzy pushing through. Mixed not able to get the kill on Ogway, not even able to wound him. Does look like Asinine goes down though. They know that there's people here.
My guys are rotating right now.
Actually, Ollie's respawning on the hab. Hotel 6 just completely. I don't know what I'm watching here. What are these two doing? What is going on here? Hulk just running circles around everybody. Nobody even turning around to shoot at him. As he turns around, he gets on top of the hab.
I have no idea.
He has his shovel
very
out.
Close, very close, he says.
He's just looking.
He's saying in the squad chat, but kind of. Oh. That would be correct. I just killed two in the prepare station.
Hulk finally going down. Oh my gosh, that was that was some very I'm gonna call that what it is. That was some terrible play here by One Shot. Just looking at him, running right by him, not engaging, not doing anything to do anything about it. That was terrible. That was absolutely terrible. But able to recover, fortunately. And we see a trade there by from Carl and Baller. As we see BMP rolling through BTRs, head back over here to West Stepney to see what's going on. As we see lots of mortars rolling around, lots of mortars falling. One shot got in a fob, or at least the radio
again.
Inside, but enemies around it, so they should know there's a radio there. Looks like that radio might be down one stage. That radio is down one stage. So wherever their hab is here, it is unspawnable again.
West step neutralized. Good job.
So that's
going
to be a problem. For one shot, they are having real trouble keeping their fobs up here on the cap zone at West Stepney. As EXD getting the flank around, they're starting to push up in the backside of one shot here. Zeppelin getting one kill, looks like maybe two kills.
They're still taking Yev.
No, we're good on Yev.
And EXD also pushing from the south side. So it's looking like one shot starting to come into some trouble here. But one shot getting that radio back up, so that hab is now spawnable again. Big save that was needed. So we quickly take a look here. We got 46 kills on the British and EXD SPH side. 52 kills for one shot. 21 and 22 on the revives, so very even so far. We got 311 tickets remaining for one shot to 296 for EXD and SPH. Lots of mortars here falling. Just mortars everywhere. But not landing where they need to be.
We're stalling their cab right now.
EXD should know where the hab is, though, as Freddy there has died right beside it. And that hab is sticking out, so if they start dropping mortars on it, that will take it down and cause some problems. As we see here, the push that was made onto Yevnivka came to no fruition. A few guys still alive up here, but full squad pushing three. That's going to end up turning out not in EXD's favor. As we see the scimitar there, now that I remember the name that I've heard it, looks like it is tracked. A-Man is repping it, but Baller not pushing it. He should be communicated to that vehicle is tracked there. Push up, try and stop the guy from repairing it, getting it out of there. Not going to matter though. Hatshot coming in, taking it out. So that was one scimitar down. 273 tickets remaining now for EXD and SPH. As sounds like the BMP and BTRs are also pushing up in here onto this north side. I don't see any more EXD. Oh, we got one, two, three. That hab is now disabled due to proximity. As they go in, they take down Sniper. Three guys on the hab. They're going to start digging that down, disabling it. Kip is going to have to come back and respond to this. But it doesn't look like he's doing it. As a fourth guy comes down now to get onto this hab. And here comes Kip, but Kip going down, unable to respond to it and react. So EXD and SPH are now capping West Stepney. They're going to get some tickets back from this, I believe, if One Shot was able to get the full neutralization on it. Let's take a quick look here. Russian battalion neutralized, Russian battalion captured. Does not look like One Shot was able to fully cap West Stepney. So that means that they're not going to get full ticket swing for capping the point back, but also means they didn't lose the tickets on that. Looks like the BMP just took a hit. Or no, 30 mil took a hit. Would have probably ended up hitting the turret, so that turret's probably really messed up. No, it looks like it's okay. I do wish that they showed or had a way to show us what parts of the vehicle are damaged and where. That would make things a lot more interesting. As BMP takes down another, the hab is completely gone. They dug the hab completely down, but nobody seems to be going for the radio yet to take that down. As another guy goes down to that BMP. BMP getting some kills. However, it's not enough to stop it. West Stepney gets capped back by the British, SPH and EXD.
Get your markers and your moves adjusted.
Getting it back. As we see EXD, Dizzy mixed, and Hulk again pushing that northwest side of Yevnivka. Trying to come back into it. 287 tickets in favor of Oneshot, 254 for SPH and EXD.
Just go there now, Seth. Just go there.
You want it?
This is certainly an interesting game going on here so far. Fighting back and forth on the West Stepney cap for the most part. Honestly, I'm surprised. Not that EXD and SPH are putting up as good a fight against One Shot Gaming's. Honestly, I don't know much about either of these teams particularly. There's a chopper getting hit, flying around, trying to get out of range. But as as I was saying, I don't know much about either of these teams or the coalition of EXD and SPH. But just based on where they got their FOB located for EXD and SPH, so far away from the cap zone, with that open field to run through, I'm honestly impressed that they've been able to fight their way through and into the cap as well as they have been. That said, they do also have a FOB over here to the east side of West Stepney. But that FOB is, again, they have that open field to go through. Though they do have a bit more cover with the tree lines and such. But we have, one shot, Zeppelin getting another FOB down here on the east side. They're going to be able to come in behind, but do they know where the HAB and FOB are over here? As we wait for this HAB to get up for the mass spawn that's going to follow. Take a look over here. A few guys from OS starting to push in. Back into the north side of West Stepney. A few people on the west side of West Stepney as well, as Facehole's dead. However, Fatty Swapper is still over there. As we see again, EXD, they're still trying to push that northwest side. I don't know why they're still doing that. They've been pushing that same angle time after time now. They need to switch it up. Come down around here over to the southwest side maybe, or maybe go for a big long hike up around to the northwest side. Drop a new rally over there.
So I'll try to do a drop two after.
But as we see over here, they found where the HAB is, as we have the BMP camping in here. But that HAB is not disabled, as Russell Brow is the only one within proxy range of that FOB right now. As bodies still aren't spawning in here on this east FOB for one shot. Not sure why they're taking so long. Russell Brow sitting over here beside the HAB, sitting in the bushes. He's going to start digging it down, but T is going to hear him digging and come around, and down he goes. Question is, did he drop a C4 before he went down? I don't know if he dropped a C4 or not. Yes, he did. He did drop the C4. Down goes Perry. So that HAB is now disabled on this east side. Two people going down inside the HAB getting killed by that C4. Well played, but more people need to start spawning on this east FOB for one shot to come in and keep them from digging that HAB back up. Lots of mortars still falling here on West Stepney. As it seems, most of the entirety of one shot is all stacked up here. Let's take a quick look at the big map. So the majority of one shot gaming is stacked up here on Yevnivka. though it does look like a few more people are starting to spawn over here on the west side. Or the, sorry, the east side of West Stepney. And I believe that, yes, that's the fob, that's the hab for SPH and EXD getting a fob inside of West Stepney to be able to fight back. Let's take a quick look over here. Squad 6 starting for EXD mixed, taken out again. Their rally's going to start getting pushed over here. Seems like with that alpha marker that they might know that the fob is somewhere over here. Or, sorry, their rally. However, it looks like Mix just spawned in and picked up that rally, and he's going to start falling back south. To try and...
Mama 9, one more Mama 10, possible.
Get a new rally up in a new position, but Martin... Running right towards Martin. Don't know if Martin knows they're coming that way, though, as they seem to run right by each other.
Helo 1 is down, 6 minutes.
Copy, heard.
Another chopper going down for Oneshot Gaming.
What's getting our helos right now?
258 for Oneshot Gaming tickets, one to 187 for EXD and SPH. I'm not sure where they're bleeding tickets from. They must be losing Vic's vehicles pretty quickly and pretty badly in order to be down that many tickets.
Because
kills are a little one-sided. 79 kills for EXD and SPH to 109 for Oneshot Gaming. And revives... But revives are a lot better on SPH's side, as they have more than 10 revives more than one shot on the Russians. We wait here, see more mortars falling. Carl getting taken out by the mortars. Infernus getting taken out by mortars. Running into the mortars, I'm not sure what they're doing. And instantly giving up, just giving away those tickets. That's probably explaining a lot of where those where these tickets are coming from. So that hab is still down to stakes, but one shot still not having taken out that radio over here. So if someone's able to sneak over and get that hab back up, that could cause one shot some more problems. They do, however, have a decent ticket lead for the moment. Captain Franklin moving in. As is Nostra, Ellie, and Zeppelin.
Can we clear out these helmet marks once you spot them and you can clear?
As we see a full squad of EXD on the north and south, or sorry, on the southeast and southwest side starting to push in. I need a drink of water here.
Infantry getting close to the F now.
There's the call out. The enemy squads are getting close to Yevnivka.
Triangle, give squad 6 the supplies for a half and come up with the
truck. Roger. As long as I can.
Pull back here over and see what's going on near this hab.
Order in placement. They haven't built them fully.
As we see Kosher.
Be sure you ignore the digging now.
Looks like, Devil is picking up Carl.
Get it.
But Captain Franklin pushing in. T4D getting tagged by Kosher. Or was, no, he might have been tagged by Captain Franklin, but T4D get taken out by someone else. At grenade, wounding Captain Franklin. But Captain Franklin taken down by... I'm just going to call you Lewis because I don't even know how to pronounce that crap.
Guys, we're losing cap.
Inbound two mics.
As the call out that they're losing the cap on Yevnivka, that call out a bit late as the cap is almost halfway down. Let's take a look here. Lots of guys here, but Bouguette. Our baguette lover going down to Hotel 6.
I feel like we're playing too fast. They're more
Swalier picking up Carl talks.
Leave him get a dig if possible.
We want 7. Keep pressure on Steph.
Are you making good ground on that pressure, or is it just moving?
Negative. Enemy VX are focused up. I'm gonna keep telling my guys to hold the front.
LPPV roughly marked on map north of Yev. Still need infantry support on Yev.
I hear a Vic here, but oh, there it is.
Gents, we have to adjust these infantry. It's
right beside that toe that's there. Lots of guys here, but doesn't seem. Oh my gosh, what the heck was that? Oh. I have no clue what that noise glitch was there, guys. I'm sorry, that just about made me go deaf as well. Holy crap. Okay, so that was a Crow taking out another Vic on the British side. So 162
mission semi
tickets remaining. Coast Guard taking out that vehicle. Still shooting up there, getting another kill.
Yeah, but if you're there, I think we can counter pressure.
Looks like EXD and SPH, though, squandering their chance to take this point. As Oneshot able to get back into this cap zone. Starting to spawn in. Crystal getting pre-fired, but going down is Asinine. Actually, one going down and two more kills for the Tiger there. Tiger getting really well in there. Good play. Looks like they're no longer capping the point as the T-72 starts to come in.
Tashar, you want me to scuttle radio at,
Looks like Whaler's still alive. And Kachimar still alive. So between the two of them, they should be able to take down this HAB and radio. As it doesn't look like there's going to be any kind of response. Oh my god. Holy crap, what is with this audio glitch stuff? I don't know what the hell's going on here, but this is terrible. I'm real sorry about that, guys. I don't know what's going on. OWI and their fantastic game. Gotta love it.
Coming in. Spawn elsewhere. Stay out of range.
Lots of audio glitches. Let me take a quick look here at my settings. Oh, everything's normal. Don't know what.
Helicopters putting gold on lower pets.
Don't know what's causing it.
It halted the capture.
Looks like they stalled the cap.
I got a command strike down for you. Don't need to use the.
And they're going to be able to get that HAB and looks like they're probably going to be able to get that HAB back up. And down goes
We're capping.
Kuchimar. Kuchimar.
Okay,
calling already in hostile position.
If you're going to call it in, put in that swamp and creep it towards Stephanie.
I got you. I'm following their
Looks like we got one guy over here on the east.
And I got mass rotations.
Fob for one shot. 225 tickets for one shot remaining to 137. Looks like that radio is down a stage. Infernus still alive. Looks like Kip pulling back. Gonna try and save that. Infernus though, bleeding out, unable to get the bandage. So Kip gonna be able to get that HAB back. Unless Cobrity is able to stop him. Looks like, was that a miss on the Vic?
We gotta start playing with,
not sure where that lat shot came from, but it must have been a miss possibly. Looks like that vehicle's pretty damaged. Ramaris looking the wrong, Unique looking the wrong way is Pupia coming back to take it. Let's see if Calvary's been able to. Yeah, looks like they got the bodies back up here they needed to be able to take this cap back. So that radio's gonna go down. That radio's gone.
Nice work. Hostile HAB should take a knock on the 926.
Ramirez is down. So that BMP or that 30 mil is just gonna be sitting there. Oof! Amen. Getting headshotted. Alright, let's see here, what do we got? Artillery barrage coming in from one shot. Looks like quite a few bodies down so far.
I haven't called it
but I don't think that's going to take out their HAB.
Let's re-rally mentally and start controlling rest.
As that HAB is still up, still undamaged, spawned back in. That artillery barrage didn't accomplish a whole heck of a lot.
Check
we got
side, yeah. Infantry pushing up.
Looks like one guy, Potato, I believe that guy's name is. Or sorry, that's two people. Manifello and Principled Potato over here at the mortar. So they'll be able to swing in from behind. Do they know the radio is over here in gas station, though? Sounds like Manifello is going to hear it. So he's going to know the radio's in here. But he just gets TK'd. Or, sorry, no,
is
that wasn't a TK.
On West Step?
He got shot over all the way from over on the island by Devil. Clutch play there by Devil to protect the radio. 202 tickets to 114 tickets in favor of one shot.
Gas station.
EXD Marking needs orders. To stop losing vehicles.
Back up, be advised.
Or EXD and SPH need to stop losing vehicles.
Borders mark accurate if they come up again.
Looks like that radio might actually be down a stage as the HAB over here does not look to be spawnable right now.
Tardies push.
That radio is down a stage. So T4D is going to have to pick that radio back up to make it spawnable again. Mortars. There's the ranging strike for the artillery. Second ranging strike. That HAB is in a dangerous spot there. It could go down from this artillery strike as EXD and SPH get ready to push in on that east side once this artillery barrage is done. Big kills from that artillery barrage. 1, 2, 3, 4 deaths, maybe 5. Go. That radio is still there. That HAB looks like it's gone. Our HAB is down to stakes. That HAB's probably going to be completely gone now, if I'm not mistaken. I'd be surprised if it's still there after all this. There's the strike finished.
Radio's damaged, I'm dropping bill right now.
HAB completely gone, radio damaged. Ramara's even going down, so quite a few kills there with that artillery strike. I'm gonna say at least 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, at least 6 deaths, possibly 7 deaths from that artillery strike. EXD has taken their time though, pushing in here after this. They need to be moving in right away, taking advantage of it, because they're going to be able to get a new HAB down and up and spawnable before they're even in. Trent going to do his best to slow them down.
Infantry vector south, southeast, yeah, accurate.
Trent getting taken down by Jinx.
They're close on our dead bodies. Yeah. 7 right.
Smoke mortars coming down in on the cap.
I hear him, Roger.
I'm taking shots while we...
Off.
98 tickets remaining for EXD.
Up now.
189 left for one shot. EXD really needing to get this capstone taken. If they're gonna manage to do anything up here. Looks like...
Copy.
Can't tell if this T-72 is tracked or not. T-72 is tracked.
Rest of us, you know what I say?
But it doesn't look like it has any actual hull damage.
With smoke mines and start retaking our front face.
I haven't seen the British tank yet. Take a quick look at the map where it might be. I've no clue, don't see it. They do have a warrior pushing down the main road. But,
guys, hold on, recapturing.
EXD not able to push in on this east side. They are getting a few bodies in on the south, but not enough bodies inside yet to start swinging this cap zone. As Oneshot able to hold onto that cap for now. Oneshot does look like they're starting to push back over to these mortars. Oh my god, what is wrong with this game today? I haven't had an audio glitch like this ever. Oh my god, okay. I'm avoiding vehicles from now on at this point. This is ridiculous. I don't know what's going on.
Radio's on me, radio's on me.
Looks like a couple EXD guys dying over there at their back fob.
West step. Be advised.
But looks like they're able to keep control of that over there. Or sorry, the south fob.
Scratch 2, Vix. IFE 2.
92 tickets remaining. 179.
So do we hold the Evol game, or do we keep trying to push step?
We want to try to push until Hundo. Maybe more.
Yep, yep.
I hear the right, call out. Oneshot wanting to keep pushing West Stepney.
So Scimitar?
Scimitar and MBT pushing up.
Franklin just crashed. He'll rejoin.
RIP.
It's not the tick rate on the server. I don't know what is causing these audio glitches and cutouts. This is ridiculous.
You want this one to rotate?
Game is definitely taking a very slow route.
Alright, here's game plans. I'm giving out independent squad orders now. 6, push this vector. 7, secure half squad northeast of Yev. Rotate some down to Bog and recover.
What was 6's push?
Look at your map. You'll see a command request on it, or a command push.
So as you can see here on the map,
at least
British command or Russian commander, Oneshot's commander, starting to give specific orders. Squad 6 is going to push the center line straight into West Stepney. What do we got over here?
Motor mark still accurate.
Looks like
the gas station.
Yes, those are up. Motor marks on gas station accurate.
Yes, those are accurate.
Friendly mortars starting to drop on the Oneshot fob over here. Lieutenant Perry goes down. Everybody's dead over here. That radio is going to be safe. Guard Martin, or Coast Guard Martin down. We're probably going to see mortars starting to land over here at gas station to counter the mortars that are already up over here for the... Yeah, there's one. Doesn't look like they're far enough, though, to actually hit those mortars. They need to push those mortars a bit further back.
No accurate mortars
to call up. Oneshot. Taking their time, though, pushing in here. Really slow moving. But, again, they have the ticket advantage of almost 100 tickets right now. All they need to do in order to win this game is not lose tickets, not give up in stupid places, not give up stupid deaths, and let EXD push into them, as EXD right now needing to get in here. 189 kills for Oneshot to 133 for EXD and SPH. 82 revives to 69 in favor of EXD and SPH.
Lost the half on Bog like twice now. What do we need to...
Just leave it.
Counter pressure. To distract them.
It's like...
They keep moving 1 plus squad.
Big mark accurate on the west side of West.
Do we have emplacement?
EXD Mad Dog just up here off on his own. What is he doing up here? T-72 taking a shot at something up there.
Scimitar pushing on Bog.
C-test.
Is he alive? No, he's not. Can't do anything about that T-72. As down goes Jamsy in the scimitar to that 30 mil.
Mortars let me clear.
One shot finally starting to make that push into West Stepney. A few bodies down for EXD SPH.
Scimitar marked.
Crispy Pixie's down.
Too much going on
right now. Cobbery's down, I think.
Scimitar stationary on mark.
Looks like he is down. Looks like he fell through the map, possibly. Mortar's coming down, taking out Whaler. Those mortars are going to make it difficult for EXD and SPH to start pushing north again, up through the town, and give One Shot the chance to come in here and start neutralizing this cap zone.
Scimitar down.
Enemy on west. Scimitar and LPG
awesome, good work.
Down.
47 tickets remaining, more vehicles dying. 30 mil pulling back. So, from what I've been hearing through the comms, as I can't seem to get in your vehicles to see vehicle fights going on without my audio getting completely buggered up, is by far the vehicles for One Shot Gaming just absolutely dominating SPH and EXD's vehicles. As I don't think I've seen a single vehicle or a single heavy vehicle on the Russian side go down, but I know I've seen at least two or three, or at least three heavy vehicles from the British go down, and I've heard at least two or three more possibly. Logi truck pushing in on the west side here. Looks like they're going to try and possibly get another fob up. Yeah, there's the radio. Dropping the supplies, they're gonna drop the HAB. As we see Baller and Usher on the HAB getting the proxy.
Take it with proxy their HAB, Mama Niner, West Step. We're trying to cap Step now. One third capped. They're still up.
Yon Motor. Looks like he's picking up, getting the revive. They need to start pushing in here. Frag grenade going in.
Oh, they're coming in.
Baller going down. Grenade.
Their HAB sticks. There's contacts immediately.
And Tusher going down. So SPH able to get the recovery, take back that HAB. 128 tickets remaining, 40 tickets remaining for SPH and EXD.
We're holding Yev. Let's get a support HAB.
Looks like they're gonna call the defense, call back for the defense now. That might give EXD and SPH the opportunity they need to push in and get. You have Nifka, but it's going to be hard now because every person on One Shot is going to be defending.
Move it.
That you have Nifka cap.
Before you got anybody else with you.
Negative. So we see Rude Awakening still up, getting another kill. Lots of explosions going off. Rude Awakening getting wounded from grenade launchers. Rude Awakening bandaged himself.
Challenger phone, South Road marked.
Looks like Rude Awakening's just gonna hold that corner. No, he's gonna look.
Pushing north.
Gonna whiff his shots. Getting one kill. But he whiffs his shot on Swapper. And Swapper pulling out his grenade launcher and putting a GL into the building. Clutch play by Swapper. And a complete full auto whiff from Rude Awakening. needed to take his time. Just semi-auto. Pop, 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 pop. Two deaths.
Like I keep saying, gentlemen, habs indoors at all points.
Would have been great, but...
This venue is placed poorly as well. We need to focus on trying to dig it back up.
As the mortars for EXD and SPH taking down the hab on... You have Nifka for one shot, as well as taking the radio down a single stage. So they're going to need to try and get this... Fob and Hab back up and in operation. But again, like you heard called out in the squad lead comms, Oneshot just constantly putting their Hab out in the middle of the open here. Ooh, Tushar going down. Ellie going down. Beautiful time mortars. Perfectly timed for the recovery there.
Tevin, can you move up and try?
That's going to cause Oneshot a problem. But EXD not in a position to capitalize on that Hab being down. They have no squads in position to really put pressure onto this cap zone right
now.
120 tickets remaining for Oneshot Gaming. 38 remaining for EXD and SPH. Mortars falling on the south side. Looks like they stopped the mortars here on the Fob and Hab. So Oneshot gonna turn around, try and come back and take this.
17 tickets. Let's make it last. We can go for the hour. We've got 3 minutes left, anyways.
They have your squads. Don't give up when they die.
Yeah. 30 mil rolling around the north side.
Man, backup half set.
Again, Oneshot's vehicle play has been on point. I don't think they've lost. More than maybe one vehicle all game, other than the chopper early on. Whereas EXD and SPH, they've lost a lot of vehicles this game. Looks like the tow Kippy there, or Kip there on the tow, getting a shot in on what I'm going to assume is either the Scimitar or the Warrior.
Knocking out the hat, they're shooting at you.
No. On the British tank. So that tank gonna have to retreat, go back to main. Some Oneshot Gaming guys back here on the west side, southwest of
just ammo.
Roger that.
West Stepney. So they're gonna start slowly pushing their way through and pushing their way in. As EXD looking like they're starting to kind of got a stalemate going on here. As both teams are looking over the swamp, neither team really wanting to push their way into it or move into the swamp.
Copy that. Already inbound, that's ours. We're good.
Artillery strike inbound. Friendly artillery coming in on west of Nivka.
They're not as critically set up as we thought. We definitely can take these guys with good strats.
Where is...
Good job, guys. Good fucking job.
Right, let me look here. Enemy artillery and friendly artillery coming in on the caps at the same time. So we got the British artillery going in first on the Fob and Hab over here on the west side of West Stepney. And I believe we're going to start seeing the ranging shots come in for the Russia, or for the British artillery soon. Couple dead bodies.
Yeah, I don't know what the command
seems. 25 tickets remaining. There's the first ranging shot. As you see, one shot. See one shot starting to push their way into the buildings, trying to hide, bandaging themselves up. A few kills for the Russian artillery strike. As here comes the British. One kill, two kills.
Mortars have moved, by the way.
Looks like they're only gonna get those two kills. Oh no, everybody in that building died from that other strike. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kills now. With that artillery strike. And. One, 102 to 122, looks like timer ran out.
Yeah, we have another match to play, boys.
Good job. Yeah, good game, boys. Good job.
All right, so that ends round one. Good to take a look here. Naughty Revives, 107. So actually pulling it back there, one shot. 214 kills to 160 kills for one shot gaming. So that's going to end round one. As we go into the intermission here, we're going to be flipping servers. So intermission might take more than 5 minutes. But we shall see. I'll meet you all guys back here for round two, coming up shortly. All right, looks like we're getting ready here for round two. All right, let me quickly do some things here. Wait, what the heck? Why am I on one shot side still? I need to be... That doesn't make sense. I should be over here. Okay. That's better. Wait a minute, what?
Advance and secure.
There we go. There we go. Okay, I'm on the right side now. Looks like both teams are still missing people. I'm not sure if we're starting here or not. Give me a second here to update the tickets from last round. So, Oneshot Gaming had... They were up 102 tickets. Two. 22 tickets on SPH and EXD. I do not plan on doing the math here. Actually, pretty easy. It's there. Eh, fuck it. I'll do the math. So, Oneshot Gaming after the first round was up 80 tickets over SPH and EXD. Game changer definitely being the Vic play for SPH and EXD. They seem to be losing Vics left and right. They lost at least two scimitars, I think three actually, their warrior a couple times. Just not able to keep their vehicles alive. They were able to hold on to West Stepney basically the entire game, though. But again, the kill difference, which wasn't huge, but was enough. And the vehicles difference is what made that ticket difference. So here we go. We're going to... Looks like we're... going to do a double roll switch... I believe. So this is not live yet here, so I'm just going to leave my squad for now. As we wait here for the next round to start, I want to thank everybody for joining me today for the cast for the game. This is Just a reminder, this is the Squad Masters League. It is a different league, new league that has just been created. This is season one of the league. This is also game one of the entire tournament between Oneshot Gaming and SPH and Exodus. Winners over that first round being, again, Oneshot Gaming with a 80 ticket difference. So SPH and EXD needing to make up that 80 tickets this round. Not sure how they're going to manage that or what they're going to do different from last round, as they seem to have good control over West Stepney for the entirety of that game. But they were getting outkilled that little bit that they were. I don't think it was an 80 ticket difference on kills, but definitely the ticket difference came down to the vehicle kills, as Oneshot Gaming was able to run all over them with the vehicle kills. So it looks like we still got a few minutes here, so I'm going to put it back to the intermission screen, and I'll bring us back once we get things going for round two.
We call an escape.
Alrighty, I think we're ready to roll here now. I think game's going to be live on start. We have players loading in. We have one OS guy that needs to be moved over. Shit. All right, being called again, not live. We're having more technical issues. Oy, oy, oy. Da baranak. Kale estich. As I butcher the French language. So it looks like we are not going to be live on start, so we're going to have to do another roll, flip, more kajiggery-doo, didgery-doo, fuckeroo, whatever, shit. So yeah, we'll be back!
Take you to the moon and back. I wanna fucking make you feel all that. I want your hands up in the air real high. I wanna go until we touch the sky. And we up, so drink up and smoke up and go up till we touch the sky. And we up, so drink up, smoke up, we up, we up. And we never wanna go, whoa, go home, whoa. The fun is all we know, whoa. Cause we up, yeah, we up, yeah. And we never wanna go, whoa, go home, whoa. The fun is all we know, whoa. Cause we up, yeah, we up, yeah. Drink up, smoke up, we up, we up, we up. And we never wanna go, whoa, go home, whoa. The fun is all we know, whoa. Cause we up, yeah, we up, yeah. And we never wanna go, whoa, go home, whoa. The fun is all we know. We'll be right back.
военной перегруппировки.
Alrighty, game is going to be live on start. Sorry that took so long, guys. Players were having connection issues. They kept disconnecting while joining or not being able to join at all. We should have all that sorted out, and things will be starting here in just under 3.5 minutes. Alright, all squads are up. Let's get myself up. So last round, we were following the perspective of Oneshot Gaming. I'm probably not going to understand much of this team's comms. As I know, SPH is Squad Spain. So they're going to be speaking Spanish. And unfortunately, I don't speak Spanish. I don't even speak French. I'm not multilingual. I'm sololingual, plain old English. I'm not sure where Exodus is from. I'm assuming they also speak Spanish as well, seeing as who they are paired up with. So we have, again, if you're just joining us, vehicles for the round for this game are 3 Logi trucks for each team and a delayed transport, a LPPV for the British, a Scimitar for the British, a Bulldog for the British, and Warrior for the British. 2 Tigers for the Russians, one of which is a open top and the other is a Crow. 2 BTR-82 30 mils and a BMP-2. Each team gets a tank, and each team gets 2 choppers, which are also on a delay. The fight for the game is going to take part over, again, Yevnifka and West Stepney. The first 3 cap, or the first 3 cap zones generally are pretty easy for the Russians to be able to take. The first 2 cap zones for the British are generally pretty easy to take. The middle point is Yevnifka, which Oneshot Gaming was able to hold the entire game. But they were unable to push into West Stepney and take a foothold properly. Even though they had a fob up on that north side right at the start of the game. EXD and SPH, though, what killed them last game was their vehicle play. They were not able to keep their vehicles alive. And they were not able to keep their vehicles going. Oh, what the heck is this? Alright, there we go. That got rid of all those stupid lines and marks. Lovely game. Squad normally not so bad, but today there's been lots of glitches. I've had lots of audio glitches. Made me go deaf almost a few times. Not so fun. But here we go. We got 40 seconds remaining. EXD, SPH, going to be rolling out here down this main road. Let's turn on the mesh for the cap zones. So let's see what they're gonna do. Who do we have here? So we got we got an extra ref in this game, this round. Okay, awesome. I was wondering who the third camera flying around was. So this round we got three refs. Or sorry, two refs and myself at casting. As we see EXD and SPH making their rollout. Little bunched up, clumped together. And what on earth is going on here? Playing bumper cars on the way out of main. That's not what you want to see out of a competitive team here. As we see one EXD Logi taking a little detour route. Both these, all the rest of the vehicles following the main road. BMP, not sure what they're shooting at. Certainly can't see anything yet.
If anyone flips their vehicle, you're getting banned.
Okay, you
did they flip a vehicle already? Well, it looks like the BMP just spun out. Okay. So, looks like pretty standard boogieing right up into West, or into Yevnivka with the Logi trucks. 30 mils are going to go down probably that eastern road. Looks like squad 1 probably going to boot it into the east side of West Stepney. Squad 3 is looking like they're going to do that. Squad 1 going to set up a fob here at Yevnivka. Or not. They're going to push past Yevnivka, dropping a guy off. Probably going to try and cap it just with a solo player. Risky move. It looks like they're going to go all in on West Stepney. Squad 3 going to set a fob up over here, out in the little outbuilding, then stretch the hab into East Stepney. Let's see where Oneshot Gaming dropping their stuff. Looks like they're still bringing their vehicles in. So they're probably going to set a fob up on gas station. Let's see where this other Logi truck is.
Keep pushing south as well.
Yeah, it looks like both Logi trucks are going to push into gas station. Possibly up even further into the cap zone. So the radio is in the trees out in the open. Again, more fobs out in the open. A little hidden by the bushes, not going to be easy to spot and find. But still, if that radio is discovered, Mortar's just going to absolutely decimate it. And the hab, they're not even putting the hab inside a building. There's a building less than, 50 yards ahead of them. Just put the hab in the building, it's protected from mortars. Not sure what's going on this game with people not putting fobs inside of buildings. Habs inside of buildings. Just mistakes all around. Not something you generally see in comp games. As we see, the choppers are in play now. So where are we going to see here? Did they stretch the hab up here? Or does not look like it. They put the radio inside the building. And no, yep, they did stretch the hab up inside the cap zone. But SPH Waller already on the fob, taking down 1-2. SPH Waller taking down 2. Looks like he's falling back to reload. SPH Waller taken down by Principal Potato. Good recovery. As I screw up my camera there. A little fight over the wall here.
It's got 7.
Good trade, good trade.
Right,
a little bit of a lag kill there, I'm going to assume. Rude Awakening coming up just to make sure that Carl is dead. And it looks like he's probably going to pick his buddy up. Or just keep running past. Look to start engaging in Furnace.
Squad 6 at the moment.
He's looking just down the road. Or, and Furnace is dead as well, actually.
Oh, no.
Trent dragging his buddy back into cover to pick him up.
I'd smash Squad 6's position with mortars as far as you.
EXD has good control over this east side of West Stepney so far. But they need to start pushing in. Try and pressure this HAB here. As we hear Oneshot mortars already up, already going to start doing business. However, the Tiger, and I'm going to pull away here before it starts shooting so I don't get that stupid audio bug again. Motel 6 and Oogway, I believe, are on the mortars.
Gas station, I think.
As they're calling out mortars on gas station.
Squad 2 vehicle, you're gonna want to move hit mortars there.
And down goes one mortar tube. Not sure why they didn't get off the vehicle or those mortars when this vehicle started driving around them in the first place. As looks like they're gonna take out a Lodgy truck with that Tiger. So getting some tickets back. Making sure that they're not losing tickets with those vehicles. 328 to 307 so far in favor of EXD and SPH. But Oneshot Gaming starting to take back territory inside the city. Pushing their way north. Enemy EXD and SPH dropping mortars on gas station on the north side, while it looks like Facehole, Ferry Swapper, or Fetty Swapper, and Hulk are starting to work their way around on the flank of this FOB. So they know the radio's probably going to be in one of these buildings here on gas station, based on where the HAB location is and where the mortars are. Down goes Tralala. Oh my god. Again, with that fucking goddamn bug. Swear to god, this is making it almost unbearable. But it looks like a warrior up on the hill. It's going to take out Zoe and Lieutenant Perry.
Squad 6
and the Tiger. Hulk taking down Manifello, but it looks like OS is starting to push back, realizing their radio is going to be under pressure and under attack.
I think that the
EXD and SPH still holding on that north side, but Oneshot Gaming definitely pressuring them on the west side, though they did lose the heavy presence they had on this northeast side as SPH is pushed back in. It looks like a trade there between Kakamar 40 and Okapro. I apologize if I'm butchering these names. I really am. Awakening is dead, so EXD and SPH should have a clear shot to start pushing up before Trent and everyone else on OS can start retaliating and pushing back. Jimmy Hammer around here still probing, harassing them on the south side by their radio. As the mass spawn starting in again over on the HAB on the east side of West Stepney.
We're losing the
Looks like everybody's dead. On Yevnivka, nobody is in the cap zone for EXD and SPH on Yevnivka. They need to get that cap.
All
it's going to take right now is just one person from SPH to get inside this cap zone, and they're going to start taking it. And this could end up turning into a roll. As we see Oneshot Gaming have a fob up behind... they don't have a fob up behind. It looks like they're taking out a EXD fob. So, EXD and SPH losing their fob back here to the northeast of Yevnivka. They have no fob on Yevnivka. They're losing their fob here as it looks like the radio is... The radio's bleeding out! They've completely lost this fob back here. SPH running back. I don't think he's going to get here in time to save this radio. As Bobby is sitting there, camping it. Ready to take it out, and Bobby gets the kill. So Bobby, with the clutch, taking out that fob here. That SPH was relying, and EXD was relying on the north side of West Stepney. Oneshot Gaming just absolutely outplaying them right now. 321 to 330 for tickets. So that ticket advantage that SPH and EXD had has already started to come unraveling.
We lost the hopping. Where's Stephanie, guy? We need our...
And looks like...
We can.
We are going to
SPH is able to get another fob in Yevnivka. Looks like they're starting to finally cap the point. And they're dropping a hab. Looks like this hab is still up and spawnable. Doesn't look like it's taken down, just its red for a glitch in the game. So we see EXD and SPH. Now they're having to survive off rallies only on this cap zone. As we see Bulldog pushing into the cap, looks like they're going to possibly load some people up in that Bulldog. Probably try and drive it straight into Yevnivka. Furnace goes down, taken out and behind by Ellie. Looks like Jinx and Ellie... Jinx taken down by, I'm not sure who took that guy down. I think it might have been the Saw Gunner there. Or no, that would have been the Saw Gunner of Unique Noodles there in the Crow Bulldog.
Got enemy armor on West 78.
One shot. Looks like for now they're content just fighting over... West Stepney, making sure they get full control over this, take out all the rallies and everything before they start worrying about pushing Yevnivka. They did have an opportunity there, though, with it being uncapped, that they could have started possibly getting a roll going. As I see a radio down, but I don't see a hab. And it's not supplied, so big mistake here. As Yevnivka is still only being protected by a single rally. So Oneshot Gaming is still having a big opportunity to be able to push into Yevnivka and do some serious damage. As we take a look at the map here, looks like Oneshot Gaming still have one or two people up here to the north. Like starting to push up into East Novos, trying to see where that spawn is that they're pushing in from over there. But they have full control over the entire south side and middle of West Stepney. Meanwhile, EXD and SPH surviving right now off that East Stepney fob and the rallies there on the north side. But those rallies are getting awful close to being crushed. Captain Franklin just needs to push a little bit further south, and there goes the one rally. Herring still alive, bandaging, saved himself. Mass spawn on the rally there, but Franklin taking one, or hurting one. Two down, Dizzy going down, and there goes the rally. Sick Pro takes out that rally, pushes around, hops the fence. And knife kill by Okapro. Just taking his time to get that knife kill. And he gets another kill on Rainbow Puffle. So that's going to be all that is for EXD and SPH here on the cap zone. As it looks like... Where's the hab here on this area? So it's over here in the building. Looks like Menfellow might know where that hab is. Don't see any enemy marks for it yet on the map. But now EXD and SPH have that entire field they have to cross in order to get into the cap zone here on West Stepney.
Alright, more habs lost. We're going to rebuild.
Lots of mortars dropping on Yevnivka right now. But there's nobody inside the cap to, for them to hit. But finally,
we're
SPH.
We'll try and get mortars up there.
Getting some bodies up into the cap zone over here. Looks like Costguard Martin and Biggie Brotox starting to push their way in. As Whaler, Baguette Lover, and who's that other one? SOCOM trying to defend this southwest corner or southeast corner. Martin taking a hit, bandaging himself. And smoke mortars start rolling down. As we have Scrub Rex in the cap zone now on the southwest side. Anybody else with him? Achilles is with him. Scrub Rex coming up behind Patton. Don't know if you saw him or not there. Yep, Patton down by Scrub Rex. But Biggie Bro taken down by Whaler. So Whaler knows there's people over here that they're going to have to contend with. Looks like Whaler and Achilles are going to meet each other head on. And Achilles is going to get the kill. SOCOM and Baguette Lover are just sitting there hiding in that building. Here comes Unique Noodles. Let's take a look over here and see what's going on. SPH and EXD just dying in that valley there. Captain Franklin just holding it down. Looks like he's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kills so far there. Captain Franklin coming in clutch, just holding this flank down, stopping an entire squad in their tracks. Does look like a couple guys from SPH have made their way through the field, though. As Carl hears the, I believe that's the scimitar pushing past him. Looks like the mortars are starting to get pushed in on by SPH guys here. As Oogway goes down, Hotel 6 still on his mortar, not hearing the shots. Okay, now he's been communicated to, now he knows that someone's near them on the south side, looking for those bodies. See here. Looks like Jimmy Hammer's still up. Actually, Ollie in Hotel 6, though, still holding it. Chopper comes in, gonna land, drop some more supplies. Lieutenant Perry taking some shots at the chopper. Not sure what he's gonna accomplish there, though. He doesn't have anything that he can take out a rotor with. Looks like the grenade might have killed. Looks like he actually might have been shot and died. Given up already. 229 tickets for SPH to 304. Almost 100 ticket difference already. In favor of Oneshot Gaming. As we see Captain Jack, or Jack John and Winter sitting inside the cap as Carl in the cap zone as well, but by himself, not a whole lot he's going to be able to do. Let's take a look over here, see what's going on. One-shot gaming looks like, down goes the Bulldog. EXD, SPH starting to push in back into, you have Nifka in force. Few guys here for One-Shot Gaming, though, still on the east side. They have a rally there, so they're going to start pushing in. I don't see... I see Zeppelin still up over here on the southwest side. Southwest side. Looks like there's a hab here that he can't dig up, but there is... Russell's been picked up, and he's alive. He's getting this hab up, so... EXD and SPH going to be in big trouble here once this hab comes up. They're going to be able to spawn in and push in pretty hard. Calling out a... EXD calling out a fob east to the southeast of Yevnivka. Incorrect call out. The fob is actually southwest of Yevnivka. The spawn that they think is over here is only a rally. So as they commit over to this flank... Once that hab is up and people start spawning in, they're going to push in from the west and get in behind these guys pretty easily. As we also see off in the distance there, Coast Guard Martin and Achilles and the rest of the boys there pushing around on the east side. The west side around in behind them. So it looks like they put the hab in a building on the cap zone. And then left the hab, or put the hab up on the hill in the trees, where it's going to be in the open for mortars to be able to come in and decimate them. Not sure what EXD and SPH are thinking with these fob placements. Just not the smartest plays, but looks like they know the hab is here for One-Shot Gaming on the southwest as mortars are coming in on it. Down goes Okapro.
I'm almost good.
Big Pimp. He needs to stay inside that hab and start digging, keeping that to keep that hab up from going down. So the call out might have been wrong, but apparently they got the mortars down on the correct hab for the defense. But looks like Squad 8, Coast Guard, Martin, and Achilles, Coast Guard on the hab here on the northeast or northwest side of Yevnivka. Crystal coming back to respond. Achilles is now in proxy range, so that hab is no longer spawnable. But it looks like 1, 2, 3, 4 people, 5 people coming back and responding to... Sorry, 6 people actually coming back and responding to it. Coast Guard Martin still up. Achilles still up. Martin on the roof. Martin going down, though. Looks like the 30 mil might be shooting friendlies. Or no, he's shooting down into the trees. Scrub Rex still up. We have 2 people in the north or in the south side of the cap zone. Those mortars are still up, or that hab is still up even with the mortars dropping. Take a look at the big map, see where those mortars might be up now. So it looks like they dropped a new fob for mortars over here on the far east side of the map. And it looks like One-Shot Gaming has taken out the East Stepney fob. So they now have full control over the entirety of West Stepney. And Squad 2, with an SPH squad, still harassing them back here on the south east side of Gas Station and West Stepney Cap. But the few of them that are there, I don't know if they're going to be able to actually do much. Squad 7 here. Jinx looks like he's looking in at the hab. Taking a couple people out. Tralala going down.
Squad 8, infantry south of you.
But Jinx is hit. Gonna have to bandage himself. Looks like Russell is still up inside the cap zone. More bodies, though, for Oneshot Gaming need to start working their way in here. Looks like a miss from that second lat. Mistakes. That Warrior's now only, or the Scimitar actually is only tracked. I believe that's that's the Warrior. Sitting here, tracked. Winter repairing it, trying to get the rep up. Get that track up so they can get the heck out of Dodge. Kochamar could easily, maybe not. No, he doesn't quite have an angle on him, doesn't know Winter's there repairing it. But Winter's still there repairing that Warrior. Takes a long time to get those tracks up. As Kochamar takes out one, and the track's up, Warrior's pulling out, smoking up, falling back. Let's take a swing over here, see what's going on. Looks like EXD or the SPH guys might actually have this radio might have finally been able to take it down. Let's see here. No, radio is down one stage. And Lieutenant Perry goes down. So Oneshot Gaming able to come back and save this fob. Well played.
We need another hub, guys.
Still a couple people up here.
Maybe in the northwest or northeast.
I reckon maybe if we could try and get a hab on my move mark, I reckon that might be a good attacking and defending.
It doesn't look like any other SP or EXD SPH guys pushing around. Capzone's basically empty of both teams, only one player from each team inside the capzone. Looks like Oneshot Gaming starting to finally push in, trickle into the capzone. As so does SPH and EXD pushing back into the south side, or to the north side of Nifka. Pardon my belch. Let's take a look at the tickets again. 152 tickets remaining for EXD and SPH. 228 for Oneshot Gaming. Oneshot Gaming with the big ticket lead in this round so far, and they are up 80 tickets after the first round. EXD and SPH needing to figure something out, come back and get this ticket difference down. Otherwise, they're going to be coming out of this first round with quite the ticket differential moving forward in other rounds. Captain Franklin's still alive there on the north side. As Predalion gets taken down. It's Captain Franklin pushing up towards the hab. That hab normally I would suspect be gone if it weren't for Squad 2 back there on gas station at West Stepney harassing that mortar fob. Otherwise the mortars probably would have taken that hab down by now. But Okapro... Ramara's starting pushing on this north side. Ramara's taking a kill, getting a kill. Ooh, grenade going down, taking out Okapro. But it looks like it damaged Elocrisius at the same time. That might have actually been a friendly GL that killed him. Not entirely sure. Ramara's taken down by Rainbow.
Something like that.
SPH up in the hill still on the north side, but Oneshot Gaming taking over the north building slowly. But back here on their fob, Jinx and Crystal have been able to push in here onto the hab, so the hab is disabled between the proxy from Jinx and Crystal. Crystal, I believe, probably pulled out her shovel and started digging this hab down. At least that would be the smart play. Yeah, it looks like the shovel's out. No animation there. Lack of an animation bug.
Alright.
Well, so it looks like everybody's dead that can push back and save this hab. So good play there by Crystal and Jinx to be able to take that fob down. Or sorry, take that hab down at least. I don't think they know where the radio is. Our radio is marked, actually. Our radio is marked by helmet marks, not actually a radio marker. But here comes off the rally to try and save that hab as they get a hab down a stage. Doesn't look like they know where the radio is or where to look for that radio.
Down first layer at Yev.
One Shot Gaming still have that presence on the north side. Kosher. Rainbow Puffle getting the revive on Crispy just in time for Trenti to run out in front of him. GL's taking out Okapro and Creeper. Or a Keeper, sorry. As the Russian chopper flies over, Lieutenant Perry's still back here harassing that mortar fob. But SPH and EXD look to be getting another fob up on the northeast side of Yevnivka, but does not appear to be that strong of a presence still around the cap. They got a decent presence. Oh, finally, okay, they got bodies back in on the south side. But Jinx and Kachamar and Crystal fell back off this hab. It didn't go looking for the radio in the right spot. Or went looking for the radio in the completely wrong direction. So now that hab is back up and spawnable. And One Shot Gaming is going to take advantage of that and start pushing in towards
so
the cap.
I think the strategy is defend, right?
But northwest...
Yep, at this moment,
or straight north and northeast of Yevnivka, they've got two fobs up now on EXD and SPH. It looks like BMP, or not BMP, apologies. Warrior takes down the BMP-2, takes down a... BTR, I believe that was, and the other 30 mil there is rolling around, moving away. Does look like the
Yevnivka enemy hab on the fire mission.
BM.
He's only down first layer. We could do some support because they're back there.
Looks like the this is a BMP as well. I'm not entirely sure what vehicle that you. That's the
West Stephanie.
Yeah, that's the. That's the warrior. And warrior gets a couple infantry kills there. Crystal flanking around trying to find the radio this time, hopefully. But by themselves, so they're not going to be able to probably take that radio down before a response is able to happen.
Be going around a warrior on the high mark.
Crystal on the radio now. Radio's down one stage. So Ramirez needs to look and react to this. Crystal, though, stopping after taking it down only one stage. But Tralala coming up behind Crystal, taking Crystal out. Very good play there. Whoa! Not entirely sure what that noise was. Artillery strike coming down in on West Stepney taking out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 people down so far from this artillery strike. Hab and everything else is still up though and functional. 61 tickets remaining for SPH and EXD though after those vehicles were lost to that warrior. So this is going to be pretty much all she wrote now. 58 tickets remaining to 204. EXD and SPH not going to have enough to come back and close that ticket differential. Unsure what the final tickets are going to be, as there was... First round, there was a small issue. One of the vehicles on Oneshot Gaming did move a little bit in main before the game had started. So unsure whether or not there's going to be a ticket penalty applied to that. Not at this point that it's going to make any difference in this game. Oneshot Gaming's more than likely, I'm willing to call it 99% likely, coming away with the W on this game. As we see, Jinx... and Kachamar back here near the radio again. If he just shot that lad at that chopper, that was a bad miss. Couple EXD SPH guys starting to push back into West Stepney, making a little bit of progress here, but I think again it's going to be too little too late. Unless they can somehow manage to take out the fob, get the ticket swing, cap this point, it's going to be all she wrote. 46 tickets to 199.
Sounds like just the one more firing.
And down goes Hulk. Down goes flying, but needing to bandage now. Trent falls back. T4D gets taken down. Grenade thrown over the wall. Doesn't look like it got anybody. Lieutenant Perry also down. That's going to be all for the push in here. So Oneshot Gaming just outplaying. Let's take a look here at the kills. 203. For Oneshot Gaming to 103. Massive kill difference. But again, EXD and SPH leading in revives, but not making any difference here as they're still down 100 kills. And down over...
The enemy radio backup.
Down over 150 tickets as well. Warrior back here. On the... getting a rep station put up for himself. Like Jinx and his buddy there both died on the radio, unable to get it down. Spawning back in on the Hab. Communist Bears, Cynics pushing back in. They're going to be running into Air Ruin and Pred Alien. Snick's going down. As there comes A-10 strike up on the Hab. Takes down the Hab stage, but doesn't take it out completely. So missed opportunity there with the airstrike to take that Hab down completely.
Let's get holding spawns.
35 tickets remaining. 179 tickets remaining for Oneshot Gaming, as it looks like they lost their scimitar there. Zeppelin and everybody else start pushing into the cap zone. Ellie taken down though by Dave thing, but Communist Bear looking to pick him up, and Dave thing down. Zeppelin now knows the radio's here. He's gonna be calling for cover so that he can take down this radio. here come the mortars. And there's the support for taking down the radio here on the point. That's going to pretty much seal the deal, as they also are probably capping the point, as they seem to have enough bodies in there now with no contestion. Yeah, no, doesn't look like there's any contestion. Jinx, the only person in the cap zone to contest it. We do have bodies down here on the south side, though. But they're all dead. And everybody's dead now. Tiger, the only thing still up on the south side. And you can't stop or defend cap zones with the Tiger. Crispy Pixie still up from the looks of it, but heavily wounded. Oh my Christ almighty. Fucking hell. God, I can't stand that. So I'm just gonna stay up here for now. So it looks like the Warriors starting to push through the town. 27 tickets remaining, 154.
Warriors, M7 hub.
Looks like a couple SPH guys working their way around, but again, doesn't look like it's going to be enough. They get a fob down back here. So we're going to have a hab back here to push into this fob here, but 17 tickets remaining, it's not going to be enough. They got to really move it quick and stop bleeding these tickets. But it looks like they're going to lose that Tiger, so there's going to be another 10 tickets. I don't remember how much that's worth. It's burning. Down it goes, 11 tickets remaining. And it looks like they're going to lose 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5 more from bleed out soon. So it doesn't look like there's going to be enough time for this fob that they place back here to the northeast, or to the southeast, to take down this fob. As they've put stuff up on the roof. They placed a mortar on the roof and are protecting it with sandbags. Interesting play. Both choppers there are down. Lieutenant Perry jousting with the guy repairing.
The tank's gonna be back up.
But 11 tickets left. They need to get in there, start taking down that radio, get that fob down. Without taking this fob, if they don't take this fob down soon, there's gonna be it's gonna be a problem. That radio's not glitched, so that's safe. Thought I'd double check that. Just a couple one-shot gaming guys left up here to defend this.
Yeah, great game. Really enjoyed playing this one.
7 tickets remaining. As you can hear, EXD and SBH calling GG already. So 144 tickets remaining on One Shot Gaming to the 6 tickets left for EXD SPH. Five tickets remaining. I see an awful lot of dead SPH EXD bodies on the map. Once they bleed out or give up, that's going to be all she wrote left. Let's take a quick last minute look here. 127 kills to 232 kills in favor of One Shot Gaming. And 96 revives to 73 in favor of SPH and EXD. So SPH and EXD, knowing what they needed to do, getting those revives, but just, again, not enough. Wasting tickets with vehicles, or losing too many tickets with vehicles, as they lost basically almost 50-60 tickets in a matter of a minute there, with the Warrior taking down three vehicles in quick succession. One ticket remaining. That's going to be all she wrote. And that's it. So 143. So that's going to mean...
GG, guys.
Nice
job, boys. GG. Always a pleasure playing with you guys.
So that's going to be it. 236 to 128 on kills.
Yeah.
Thank you.
143 ticket win in the second round. With that, going to be... Let me do some maths, because I'm terrible at maths. Pull out my calculator. As we go here to the final screen. That's going to be all she wrote. Oneshot Gaming is your winner for the game with the overall victory of 223 tickets for the overall victory. Now, that might change as, again, I stated towards the end of the match there. In the first round, Oneshot Gaming did move one of their Logitrucks forward. That could possibly come back and bite them and cost them some tickets. I believe it's 30 tickets, maybe? I'm not sure what the ticket cost is for that. It is not going to make any difference, though, however, for the outcome of this game, as Oneshot Gaming clearly... the victors in this round, especially in the second round, they could have possibly, had they been a bit more aggressive, had they been a bit more aggressive pushing Yevnivka after they took West Stepney, they quite probably, possibly could have rolled EXD and SPH all the way back to the main, because EXD and SPH did not have any fob up for the longest time on Yevnivka. But, again, this is the first round. Teams will learn, teams will improve, teams will figure out what they did right, what they did wrong. EXD, SPH, I think what they need to take away from this is they need to work on their vehicle play a little bit, as basically most of the tickets I saw lost in this game for them were vehicle-related. But that 100-kill differential definitely killed them, or definitely hurt them in the second round. The first round wasn't that big of a kill differential, but definitely in the second round, the kill differential came back and bit them in the ass. Anyway, that's it for me for this first round, first game, first week of Squad Masters. Hope everybody enjoyed. Thank you all for joining me today on this stream, on this cast. Hope you all enjoyed. Apologize for the audio glitches there. That was the game's audio glitches, not mine. I was going deaf right along with you guys with those, so I apologize for that. Hope everybody enjoyed, and I will see you all next time. Take care, and have a good one.